Hi students, how are you? I hope everybody is fine. Today we are going to deal with the defects in the crystal. We are going to deal with the crystal defects. Crystal defects. What is this crystal defects? Whenever one crystal is forming. Till now what we discussed? How the crystal is forming. How the atoms are arranged in a crystal. In a different one-dimensional, two-dimensional and three-dimensional, in these formats we discussed how the atoms are arranged in a crystal one-dimensionally, two-dimensionally and three-dimensionally we studied. Now we are going to discuss about crystal defects. What is this crystal defects? Crystal defects means whatever the atoms are there in the crystal, if they are not arranged properly, that means imperfection of arrangement of atoms in the solids, in the crystal, leads to crystal defects. See here, the defects are basically imperfection or irregularities in the arrangement of constituent particles in the solid. In a solid, some particles are there, some atoms are there, some molecules are there, some ions are there. That ions are not arranged in a proper way. There is a irregular arrangement at the time which are going to arise. Crystal defects are going to arise. Once the defect is there, that defect leads to physical and chemical properties of the solid and also play an important role in various processes. The defect also leads to some use only. We are going to study if the defect is there means sometimes we may use that defect also. Why? Physical property is changing and chemical properties also changing. Once the physical property is changing, you can use in a positive way. Once the chemical property changes, you can use in a positive way. Physical properties like melting point, boiling point, color, rigidness, they are all physical properties. Chemical properties means how it is going to react with the other species if the arrangement is irregular. Okay, now we are going to learn some crystal defects. See this. What is the use of this one? Once that irregularity is there in the arrangement of the atoms in a crystal, that leads to increase in the electrical conductivity of a semiconductor. Semiconductor means what is the meaning? Semiconductor means which is not a very good conductor, which is not a bad conductor. It is in between the medium of conductor and insulator. That is what semiconductor, which can pass the current moderately through it. That is called semiconductor. For that semiconductor, what you can add? For the semiconductor, you are adding some foreign species. That is what doping. Some other species. What is that? Some foreign species you are going to add means some other species you are going to add means after this it is acting like a better conductor than previous. This conduction property developed by adding of some other species, some foreign species. Due to adding of this foreign species, there is a irregular arrangement in the crystal of silicon, so it is acting like a good conductor. This is what the use, this is what the significance. See other one, the ability of ferromagnetic material such as iron, nickel to be magnetized and demagnetized. We can, some species like iron and nickel, we can make it magnetized. That means you can add the magnetic property by arrange the atoms in a crystal. In a similar way, you can make it demagnetized by arranging the atoms in that particular crystal by creating some imperfections, otherwise by adding some foreign species. When you are adding some foreign species, automatically there is a irregular arrangement. When the irregular arrangement is there, there is a change in the properties. That properties we can use like increasing the electrical conductivity, otherwise demagnetization, otherwise magnetization. That's what. And the next one, Crystal defects are classified as follows. The defects are like this: point defect, line defect, interfacial defect and volume defect. These four are the defects. Out of this, we are going to concentrate on only point defect in our textbook. This is what your syllabus. Point defects only. Generally, the name itself is telling. Point defect means whenever the atoms are arranged in a particular row or in a particular column. Horizontally, vertically, they are arranged. No, like this, like this. Atoms are arranging. Already we studied how the atoms are arranged. When they are arranging, if the irregularity in the location of one atom, any one atom, like a point, that atom you can consider as a that point location. The time is point that there is a irregular arrangement in that particular atom or ion or molecule, means that is a point defect. Line defect, completely this line, completely there is a irregularity in the row or in a column. At the time, line defect. Interfacial, there is irregularity in the face of the crystal, volume, due to the volume, some defects are arises. Now, in this video, we are going to study about the point defect. Mainly, this point defect is going to occur in ionic solids. Ionic solids means generally which are formed by the ionic bond. Already we studied ionic bonds, covalent bonds, metallic bonds. Molecular solids means van der Waals forces. All these four types of solids we studied at the beginning of the lesson. So that now this point defects we can observe in ionic solids. Okay, see here. Again, these point defects are further classified. We are going to study only in a point defect. What is that? Point defect only. That point defects again we are going to classify into stoichiometric defects, non-stoichiometric defects, impurity defects. In this lecture, in this video, what we are going to study is, we are going to study stoichiometric defects. In that one, Schottky defect and Frenkel defect. See, these two are important. This will come in the examination. This will come in your competitive examination like NEET and all. In this video, we are going to concentrate on stoichiometric defect, Schottky defect. Other one is Frenkel defect. See here. Initially, what is stoichiometric defect in a ionic solid? General meaning is the name itself is there. Stoichiometric defect. Due to the irregularity in the arrangement, which are not going to change. Which does not change the stoichiometry. Stoichiometry of compound, which does not change the stoichiometry of the compound, that type of defects you can say as a stoichiometric defects. Name itself will explain. Okay, and here what is it? This defect also called as intrinsic defect or a thermodynamic defect. Other definition also is there. See, when this defect will arise, whenever a crystal arranged like this fashion. Whenever a crystal arranged like this, there are positive, negative ion, positive ion, negative ion, positive ion, negative ion, there is an arrangement like this. Keep on, there will be arrangement. When this type of arrangement is there, there will be a generation of vacancy. There is a formation of vacancy. Due to what? Due to the dislocation of one negative sign and corresponding positive sign. Otherwise, any of the ion, either negative sign, otherwise any positive sign can occupy the interstitial position. Interstitial position, these gaps. See, among this ion, there is a gap. This is a gap. Fully, this is all these gaps. Whatever the blue color I am marking here, all these you can say as a interstitial sites. The gaps formed among the ions in a crystal. Whatever the gaps are there, whatever the voids are there, these are called as interstitial position. Stoichiometric defect can be generated How can it generated? By the migration of, by the dislocation of one positive ion, correspondingly opposite one, negative ion. One positive and one negative. One positive and negative, like that, they can dislocate from its original location. Otherwise, any one ion, either negative or positive ion, can relocate to, can dislocate to the interstitial position. Due to this type of delocations, we can observe the stoichiometric defect. Because of this, there is no change in the stoichiometry of the compound. Stoichiometric of the compound means there is no change in the molecular formula of that particular compound. See here. In stoichiometric, ionic vacancy of one ion must always be associated with the either by absence of another oppositely charged. Vacancy of one ion, for example, that one ion is positive means that oppositely charged ion will be negative. Both can be go out, they can form a vacancy. Okay. In a similar way, or the presence of same charged ion in the interstitial position so as to maintain the electrical neutrality. Same charged ion, any charged positive or negative can go to this place. This positive ion can come here it can come. This negative ion can come here. They are going to dislocate to the interstitial position to maintain electrical neutrality. Electrical neutrality means in a full compound, in a full crystal structure, what should be there? The charge should be balanced. Number of positive ions is equal to, that means total ion by the positive, total charge by the positive ions is equal to total charge by the negative ion. They have to maintain the crystal structure. That is called electrical neutrality. And the next one. First one, in this stoichiometric defects, two defects we are going to study. I told starting of this video, that is Schottky defect, other one is Frenkel defect. See, this is whatever you are seeing here, this is the arrangement of the crystal. Which crystal I am taking? NaCl crystal I am taking here. NaCl crystal, we know that. NaCl is ionic compound, Na plus is there, Cl minus is there. They are arranging in this way. One negative, one positive, one negative and positive. Green balls are indicated as a chlorine. Pink balls are indicated as a sodium ion. They are arranged orderly. Here I marked here for our better understanding. Here chlorine, this is a chlorine, this is a chlorine, and this is a sodium, this is a chlorine. Like that, few of the ions I indicated here. This is the sodium, this is the chlorine, this is the sodium. For understanding, we are making some arrangement in this diagram. Okay, what is the Schottky defect? How it is going to generate? When it is generated means, see, I will show. It is an arrangement. No, here there is a one positive ion coming out means, see, one positive ion, it is arranged here. This positive ion is coming out. At the same time, one negative ion also coming out. See, one positive ion coming out and one positive ion coming out, and also one negative ion is coming out. Due to this, whatever the vacancy is formed, there is a irregularity in this crystal arrangement. Now there is irregularity, you can observe here. What is irregularity? Here there is a gap, here there is a vacancy, and here there is a vacancy. How it is formed vacancy? Due to the migration of, due to the missing of one positive and another negative ion. This type of defect is called as Schottky defect. This defect does not change the stoichiometry of the crystal, because both here Na also, Na ions also, sodium ions also, one missing, chlorine ions also missing. For example, here what you can say, NaCl, initially 10 chlorines are there, 10 sodiums are there. Now one is missing, no, 9 sodiums are there, 9 chlorines are there. Anyway, the formula is NaCl only. Here also formula will be NaCl only. The stoichiometry is not going to change in a Schottky defect. And next one, see, ionic solids in which the cation and anion are almost similar size show Schottky defect. To show this Schottky defect, this cation and anion, positive and negative sign ions almost similar size. So they both can come out to arise this defect. Example is NaCl, already we are explaining that NaCl only. Next one, presence of large number of Schottky defects in a crystal lowers the density. Lowers the density, here you see. Because of Schottky defect, density decreases. Because of this defect, what will happen? Density is going to decrease. Why density going to decrease? Density means what? Density is equal to mass by volume. What is that? Density is equal to mass by volume. Let's say mass by volume. Here volume is not going to change. It is a complete volume. Whatever I am marking here, you can understand here, this is a volume. Volume of the crystal is not going to change. What you can say? Volume, this is the volume. For example, this is the one cube I will write. This is the volume. Okay. This is the volume, right? This is the volume. This volume is not going to change. That means in a density formula, D is equal to mass by volume. Volume is not going to change. Volume is not going to change. Volume is constant. Volume is what I can say, that is a constant. In a density is equal to mass by volume, volume is a constant. Whenever this Schottky defect arises, Schottky means here one negative ion missing, here one negative ion missing, here one positive ion missing. So two ions are missing. After some time, what you can say? Here one negative ion can miss, here one positive ion can miss. After some time, here one negative ion can miss, here one positive ion can miss. Like that, keep on, ions are moving outside, means they are all moving outside. It is also moving outside. It is also moving outside. One positive, one negative are moving outside, means there will be a formation of the gaps. Whenever formation of the gaps more, means the mass is going to decrease in the crystal. Number of ions decreases, mass decreases. Mass means where it is present? In a numerator. Mass is present in a numerator. Whenever numerator decreases, obviously density going to decrease. That is why, due to Schottky defect, density going to decreases. Density is going to be decreases. This is what our Schottky defect, you can observe. It is arises due to the missing of equal number of cations and anions from the crystal lattice. One positive charge is coming out means, one negative charge is going to come out. Missing of both cation and anion leads to Schottky defect. In a similar way, it does not change the stoichiometry of the crystal. That means molecular formula of NaCl is not going to change. That is why we can say stoichiometry is not going to change in a Schottky defect. And next one will be ionic solids in which the cation and anion are almost similar size show Schottky defect. To show this defect, positive ion and negative ion, cation and anion almost be similar in size. We are, example means NaCl example we are going to explain here. Presence of large number of Schottky defects. Large number of Schottky defect means many number of positive and negative ions are coming out from the crystal. When they are coming out from the crystal, mass of the crystal is going to decrease. Density formula is mass by volume. Mass value decreases means obviously density value is going to decrease. And finally, this is the other example. Already we are discussed about NaCl. And other example is vanadium oxide. In this vanadium oxide, vanadium is a positive and oxygen is a negative ion. They are also arranged in a proper way. Like this. After that, what happened? This Schottky defect observed here. See, the theoretical calculated density based on this vanadium 2 minus, oxygen 2 minus, vanadium 2 plus, oxygen 2 minus. Vanadium 2 plus, oxygen 2 minus. Like that arrangement is there. Here also, one positive and negative ion is going to missing. Due to that one, what experimentally observed density is 5.6. It indicates the Schottky defect in vanadium oxide crystal is 14%. How they are getting defect? This much is there, no? How much something is missing? That missing by, missing is how much missing? 6.5 minus 5.6. This much what is missing? By what is the initial one? 6.5 into 100. You are giving means you will get a 14%. That is the indicator Schottky defect percentage is 14% in a vanadium oxide. And the next one will be Frenkel defect. It is also other defect in a stoichiometric defect. Here what happened? Frenkel defect arises due to the dislocation of ions from its crystal lattice. It is a crystal lattice. Positive, negative, positive, negative. Negative, positive, negative, positive is there. Dislocation. Dislocation means that ion in the crystal only, but it is moving from one place to another place. See here. It is nothing is there. Actually, here one red ball. Here one cation should be there. That cation came here. Where it is coming? It coming to the here interstitial position. I will show here with the black color. You show again. This cation coming here. Observing or not? Observing or not? See, cation. All the red balls are cations. You can see small cation is there. That cation is coming from here. Actually, it should locate here. One Ag plus missing. That Ag plus coming to the interstitial position of the crystal. And here also, this is also coming from somewhere like this. This small Ag plus also coming from here. Ag plus vacancy is forming here. Here also Ag plus is missing. It is coming here. It is coming here. Due to that. But the point is here, the ion is not coming out of the crystal. It is not escaping from crystal. Just it is dislocating from its original site to the interstitial site. So the mass of the crystal will be same only. In this crystal mass, there is mass is not changing. Mass is as usually will be there. Volume also as usually will be there. But there is a dislocation of the ion from original site to interstitial site. The ion which is missing from the lattice point occupies an interstitial position. Lattice point, these are the lattice point, blue, red, blue, red, blue, red. All these points are called as lattice points. Starting of the lesson itself we studied lattice points. All these are lattice, all these blue and red balls locations are lattice points. And among this ion some gaps are there. These are all called as interstitial positions. These gaps, whatever, wherever any gap. Any gap, this gap is there, this gap is called as interstitial position. That gap is called as interstitial position. And this defect is shown by the ionic solids in which cation and anion are different size. What we studied, one cation dislocated from the original site to the interstitial site. So whenever the size difference is more between anion and cation, and obviously this cation can come and occupy the whenever it is a small one, it can come out and occupy the interstitial site. So this type of size difference is there, means this leads to the Frenkel defect. This defect does not affect the density of the crystal. Why? Again, density is equal to mass by volume. Mass of the crystal not changes. Why? Whatever the ion missing here, it is in the crystal only, but in a other place. In that room only, in that crystal only, in that crystal lattice only, in that solid only, it is not coming out. It is not coming out. It is just here only. So that mass is not going to change. As we know, volume not going to change. So density is not going to change. And example here, AgBr. Ag plus leaves the original. AgBr. All these blue color balls are bromide ions. All the red color balls are Ag plus ions. In this cation is Ag plus, small in size. It is dislocated from the original site to the interstitial site. Original sites to the interstitial site like this. Example is AgBr. The one more point here is AgBr is talking about Frenkel defect. And the point is AgBr also shows the Schottky defect. Another point is AgBr, you can take an example for AgBr, you can also take an example for Schottky defect. Okay. Now we discussed about what is Schottky defect and what is Frenkel defect. Now we are going to study the differences between Schottky defect and Frenkel defect. It is important one. It will come to your board examination. board examination, they can ask a question. Here see, first Schottky defect. Whatever we know, we are writing in the form of a table here. Schottky defect in ionic crystals arises when equal number of cations and anions are missing from the normal sites, resulting in equal number of cation and anion vacancies. That's what we studied. In a crystal, one positive ion missing, one negative ion missing, they are out, they are coming out of the crystal. That is what Schottky defect. Here, Frenkel defect in ionic crystal arises when some ion, generally cation, leaves their normal lattice sites and occupy the interstitial sites. Here, sites are there, positive is there, negative is there, positive is there, negative is there, positive is there, negative is there. Here, positive is there and negative is there, again positive is there. Like this, any site is there means this cation from this position to it is coming and occupying the interstitial position. That is what Frenkel defect. Next difference, decrease in density of the crystal, because both are escaping from the crystal, so that mass decreases, density decreases. Here they are not escaping from the crystal, they are not coming out from the crystal lattice, so that density does not change. Ionic compound with high coordination number, see here, high coordination number having cations and anions of similar size exhibit this type of defect. Whenever high coordination number means what? One atom is there, it is going to, it is in contact with some other atoms. Whenever many atoms are the high coordination number means like this. See, this atom is in contact with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Coordination number for this one is 6. For example, in a crystal, this black color atom is in contact with 6 other atoms. At that time, coordination number is 6. Whenever coordination number is 6, that means many number of atoms are in contact with this atom. Many number of atoms are there, it is packed tightly. So that whenever this defect has to arise means, there is no space among them, so that the one, both positive and negative, both has to come out, because many atoms are there, ions are there to dislocate from one place to other place, so that whenever coordination number more, so that they have to come out, they cannot occupy within the crystal, they have to come out because of high coordination, because of existing of many atoms surrounding a one atom. Come this side. It is generally observed in ionic compound with low coordination number. Low coordination number means one atom is like this. Low coordination number means what? One atom is like this. It is in contact with 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Coordination number is 1, 2, 3. So, whenever less number of atoms are there in surrounding, so that this second atom can come and occupy. What is that? This second atom can come and occupy this interstitial position. This is interstitial position, it can come here, otherwise it can come here, otherwise it can come here. It can come to interstitial position and it can occupy, and it can show the Frenkel defect. Examples, NaCl, KCl, KBr. Here examples are AgCl, AgI, ZnS. Here, as I told, in our textbook AgBr, they are explaining to the Frenkel defect. Frenkel defect, okay, no problem, you can write in the examination. But competitive wise we are going to see means AgBr also show the Schottky defect, AgBr also show the Frenkel defect. It is an example for both. AgCl, AgI, ZnS are the only example for Frenkel defect. NaCl, KCl, KBr only example for Schottky defect. If you want to talk about AgBr, it can show the both Schottky and Frenkel defect. This is what the stoichiometric defects in that Frenkel and Schottky defects. What we have to observe is both the defects are not affecting the stoichiometry of the crystal, stoichiometry of the compound. This is what we studied in this lecture. Okay, now thank you.